Hello everyone, I am Surajita Raj, going to explain endocrine system. We'll discuss what is endocrine system, what is endocrinology, what is a gland, differences between exocrine and endocrine glands, what are hormones, characteristics of hormones, differences between hormonal control and nervous control. What is endocrine system? The endocrine system is made up of endocrine glands and endocrine tissues. The science concerned with the structure and function of the endocrine glands, diagnosis and treatment of disorders of the endocrine system is known as endocrinology. What is a gland? A gland is an organ which produces and releases substances that perform a specific function in the body. There are two types of glands, known as exocrine glands and endocrine glands. Let's see the differences between exocrine glands and endocrine glands. Endocrine glands are ductless glands. They secrete their products, that is hormones, into the extracellular space around the cells. The secretions then pass into capillaries to be transported in the blood. Example, pituitary, thyroid. Then exocrine glands. They have ducts. They secrete their products into ducts. The ducts carry the secretion into body cavities, lumen of various organs or body surface. Example, digestive gland, sweat gland. What are hormones? The secretions of the endocrine glands and tissues are called hormones. Once a hormone is released into the blood, it is carried to target cells that respond to the hormone. All body cells are target cells for one or more hormones. But all cells do not respond to a particular hormone. Hormones are changed functionally and structurally as they are metabolized. They are partially used by the cells and partially excreted in the urine. Hormone is one of the most important substances that controls the body chemistry. The term hormone was first used by W.M. Ballis and E.H. Starling in the year 1902. Let's discuss the characteristics of hormones. Hormones are secreted in extremely minute quantities. The amount of hormone released is determined by the body's needs. They are secreted directly into the bloodstream and are carried by blood circulation. Their action is distant. A hormone secreted in one part of the body produces an effect in another part of the body. That is, they act on target cells or organs away from their source. Hormones are known as chemical messengers or information molecules as they modify and regulate the activity of the target tissues or organs and affect the enzyme systems of the body. They are specific in action. Organs and tissues respond specifically to the action of hormones. The response brought about in an organism by a particular hormone cannot be induced by another hormone. Also, hormones produced in one species usually show similar influence in other species. Hormones help adjust and restore homeostatic balance. Hormones help the body cope with emergency demands. Chemically, some hormones are peptides like insulin, which are water soluble, whereas some are amines. Those are derived from amino acids. Example is adrenaline. This is also water soluble. And some are steroids. Those are derived from cholesterol. Example is testosterone, which are lipid soluble. Let's see the differences between hormonal control and nervous control. All hormones are chemical signals known as regulators, whereas nerve impulses are electrical signals, and transfer of information across synapses is chemical. This is all about the nature of signal. Now the second property is on the size of signal. It is controlled by concentration of hormones, whereas under nervous control, controlled by the rapidity of the impulse, determined by the frequency of nerve impulses sent along a nerve fiber, and a large number of nerve fibers get stimulated. Then third property is on the speed of signal, usually slower by comparison, whereas in nervous control it is rapid. Next property is an effect in the body. More general effect, hormones can influence many cells in many different parts of the body, whereas in nervous control, localized effect, each individual neuron links with only one or a few cells. Next, about the capacity for modification. Cannot be modified, no learning from previous experience, whereas can be modified by learning from previous experience. The detailed study of endocrine glands we will watch in the next video. Thank you.